It's Gleed and 11 on Power 88.3. Hanging out with Logan for your Power Workday. Now, I've got someone very, very special in studio with me at the moment. And I've got a little bit of an introduction. Here we go. Oh yes. Okay. Born in 1961, he is a former urban Māori chief executive and award-winning radio and television broadcaster. He grew up in Porirua and Mangere and attended Mangere College in his teenage years. He previously worked as a trade union organiser, record company executive, broadcaster, sports talkback radio host and urban Māori advocate. Whoa, that's quite a lot. Primarily based in Auckland, he has supported the rights of Māori and urban Māori nationally for many years with a focus on community development, particularly in South Auckland. He has been at the forefront in terms of advancing community interests, local initiatives and whānau aspirations. The minister has a very long history working with both Māori and mainstream media in print, radio and television, including commentating election coverage in 2005, 2011, 2008, 2011 and 2014. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the studio the Honourable Willie Jackson. Hey. Welcome to the studio, Willie. How are you today?
Good.
Awesome. It's great to have you here. Thank you for coming in today. Now, so obviously you're here to unveil the huge funding that the Youth Employment Team and the Youth Centre have received. And so the funding is for skills training and support for youth, right?
Right.
What does that look like? Break it down for me, because I'm only 15 years old and I have no idea of the impact that this could potentially make on my life or my friend's life. So how will this impact us?
Well, it's for the people here in terms of the youth centre to wrap around services for young people who might not have had much of an opportunity. So some of those people have been on benefits, some of them have come from tough backgrounds, and basically this is a chance for them to get some training. We're hoping that they will get into work, but just give them an opportunity. Give them an opportunity. We're doing this type of work all around the country, under the umbrella. It's called He Pautama Rangatahi, so it's a vehicle for young people, but it's for all groups of people who mightn't have had a chance in life. So we've been very lucky that the community youth centre here has decided to pitch for the funding and for the resourcing, and it's very good for Rotorua because we don't want young people wandering around, doing nothing. So this is about getting in behind them, getting them the necessary skills in terms of life, looking at employment opportunities, getting them right for the future, might be possible apprenticeships, possible work, whatever. And so really pleased that they have decided to come to government to apply for funding to help the community. And these types of programs are being run in every region. Well, yeah. Just about every region around the country. Not so much down the far South Island. Not yet. But in most areas, we've got this type of program running, which is all about helping our youth and helping our communities.
Yeah, awesome. Okay, so cool. So what? I want to know what your aspirations and views for young people here in the Rotorua are.
Well, my hope is that they will get an opportunity. That's what my fervent hope is that young people get opportunities, particularly young ones who haven't had opportunities.
Yeah.
So if they get that chance to get off the benefit.
Get them into a real job. Yeah.
Well, even training, real job, what I want is we want them to get active. We want them to get motivated. They don't all have to become scientists or flash DJs like yourself. You know, they don't have to do that. As long as they start using their mind, using their bodies, get up, get running, you know?
Yeah.
And get active. So my hope is an MP and minister is that they will take an opportunity and take a chance, and that's what I want. And then they can go on and be whatever they want to do. You know, I don't have a fixed view in terms of what they should be doing, as long as they're doing something.
Yeah, so it's a bit of a stepping stone into the industry.
Absolutely.
Awesome.
Into whatever industry.
Yeah.
But the last thing you want to do is be sitting at home doing nothing.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. Now tourism has been hit hard here in Rotorua due to COVID-19, and especially as we are a town famous for our tourist attractions. But the thing is, if the attractions are not attracting the tourists and our borders stay closed until the foreseeable future, then there is no money, which means no jobs. Does that mean youth are supposed to take whatever comes to them as far as work is concerned? Or is a future post-COVID going to be ever more difficult for me and my friends to realise? Because the stark reality is that we have to change our thinking in terms of what is a realistic career moving forward, which may not align with what our dreams and aspirations are. What's the solution for that?
Well, you just said it, I think. I think that's a very good answer. That's a very good... I think there are some realities in what you just said. You know, this is not pre-COVID, this is post-COVID, and things are going to be tough for everyone. So, you know, you sometimes you have to put on hold some of those dreams and some of those aspirations. Doesn't mean to say you don't want to keep them, but, you know, this is a difficult time. A lot of people are losing work. Yeah. A lot of people are, you know, businesses are closing, and, you know, we can't save every job and every business. We'll try to. We support them as much as we can, when we can, where we can, but it's
not always possible.
It's not always possible. Yeah. You know, and so all we say to young people is be persistent, don't give up. Nowhere in tough times, you might not get your dream job straight away, but there's nothing wrong with doing a labouring job.
It's not stopping you from getting there eventually.
In my view, any opportunity is an opportunity, better than sitting at home. Yeah. Do we want good jobs? Yes, but sometimes you have to do mundane jobs, boring jobs, just to get yourself away. And so nobody should be too proud to do a waitressing job or a waiter's job or a cleaning job.
At least
or a
labourer's experience.
Job. It's experience, but that doesn't have to be, wouldn't want it to be the be all and end all, but at least it's a start, it's a beginning.
Yeah.
And have a plan going forward. That's what I say to young people, have a plan going forward and know that any sort of job at the start is just
good.
A start, and it should be part of your plan in terms of, you know, aspiring to get your dream job and turning your life around.
Yeah, and as you said, there's nothing stopping you from getting there.
No, there's nothing stopping you.
No
matter what the situation, and the situation is dire. Reality is we don't have any tourists from overseas now.
Yeah, exactly.
So obviously the tourism industry is very, very sad at the moment. But, you know, locals are coming into Rotorua. So this is a chance for locals all around the country to come into the different townships to support local businesses. But we're aware, though, that people from overseas are not coming in, so we have to roll with that. But the main thing is don't give up, no matter what the circumstances are, because they will change. It's just going to be some time.
Yeah, awesome. Okay, so that's the easy questions out of the way. Now come the hard ones. I'm going to play a game with you. It's called Name Association, and basically I'm going to say a name, and I want you to give me the first word or words that pop into your head, but please, there are some names there that might make you want to curse, but please, only clean words, please. Okay, so here we go. Let's start this, let's kick this off. So, first name, Winston Peters.
Good man.
Good answer. Winston Jacinda Ardern.
Oh, magnificent leader.
Magnificent leader, all right. David Clark.
Oh, good man.
Good man, still a good man after what he did.
Well, he didn't do anything. He did a good job in terms of health. Made a few mistakes, but absolutely good, decent New Zealander.
Awesome, Ashley Bloomfield.
Oh, he's a bit of a rock star.
A bit of a rock star. He's a pretty good rock star. John Tamahere.
A bit mixed up fella. But he's the brother. He's the brother.
Awesome.
But a mixed up one.
Mike King.
Well, Mike is a huge talent. Huge talent.
Awesome. Now, this is the second to last one. I don't know if you're going to go off of this, but Donald Trump.
Yeah, a bit of a mixed up bloke too, like coming in.
You're comparing him to John Tamahere.
There's some similar traits here. Yeah.
Awesome. Now, last one. What do you think about a Power 88.3 National Youth Radio Network?
Yeah, I think it has possibilities.
That's the answer we want.
Depends
to hear.
Who's fronting as a DJ. And after your performance today, I'm still thinking about it.
Wow, okay. After that comment, I don't know if we're getting you back, Willie. Oh, wow. Well, thank you so much for coming and having a chat with me today. It's been awesome to have you in here, and just have you come and support the youth here in the Rotorua.
Yeah, that's good. Awesome. Yeah, no, well done, and you keep up the good work.
Thank you.
No, well done to yourself and to the team here, and it's been good. You've been learning Māori? You learn Māori?
Well, that's actually what I was going to say, but I don't know if I should say it on air.
Oh, where you go.
It's about a new program, the Te Reo classes. Oh, thinking about that.
Kapa, you're doing some Te Reo on air?
Or? Well, we could possibly.
Oh, no,
possibly.
You're going to do some, are you?
Maybe, yeah.
I want you to do that. That'll be good.
All right. I'll write that down. That can be on the list.
Okay.
Awesome.
Kia ora.
Thank you for coming in, Willie. Coming up, music, new music from DaBaby. Bow. Hip-hop. Bow. Come on. Power. 88.3.